Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we're here to determine the general equation of all these lines A, B, C, and D, okay? So the idea is, what is the general equation? Well, in this case, we're going to do the AX plus the BY, okay? And we're going to use the plus C on this side, actually. And it really depends. Some textbooks, some have the C on this side, some have the C on the other side. But in this case, let's use this way, okay? So, how do we get the x, y, and the constant? Okay, let's say let's do the first one for example. So, my equation number A, which is this one over here, let's do the slope and the y-intercept equation first, and then we'll change it into the standard form, okay? So, by looking at this one over here, it's really hard to figure out the y-intercept. You know why? Because it's kind of far away, okay? So this is going to take me a little some time, but we do know the slope. It's going up by 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, sorry, going up by 6 first and over 2. So the slope for the first one is actually 6 over 2, which is going to give you a 3, right? Okay, so it's just going to give you a 3 as a slope. But where is the y-intercept, okay? Now, because I don't have enough graph to see the y-intercept, but I can solve it. Do you know how to solve it? Well, you do know one of the points, don't you? Okay? Let's say let's pick this one right here. Let's pick the negative, that's a 5, 6, 7, 8. That's a negative 8 and 0. So if you know you have an equation that says y equals mx plus b, right? And you do know the slope is a 3, right there. And you do know the x is a 0 because you just picked the negative 8. Sorry, your x is actually negative 8. So you picked the negative 8 for the x. And your y value is a 0, then the b is just right over here at the very end, okay? So 8 times 3 is actually negative 24. And if you bring it over to the other side, guess what's going to happen? It's going to give you that 24 equals to the b, okay? So that means this equation here is now going to look like this. Y equals to 3x plus 24, okay? So that's the slope and the y-intercept equation for my line number A right here. But how do we change it into a standard equation? Well, the standard equation says it has to be ax plus by plus c, right? So why not just leave the x right there? It looks good. Okay? Bring the y to the other side, so because negative y and plus 24. And this is your standard equation for line A. Does that make sense? Pretty straightforward, right? You found the equation first, and then you just switch it around, then you get yourself a beautiful general equation, okay? So that's line number A. So what about B? B, it looks, I'm not really sure what a y-intercept is, but if I kind of just follow this line here, okay, I think it's a fraction rather than like a perfect number. So let's try it one more time with all these things that we just did. So if you're looking for the B, find the slope. We're going up 1 over 2, but it's a left 2. So the slope is up 1, but left 2. So it's negative 1 over 2, okay? But what about the y-intercept? Let's say I'm not too sure about this point, which I actually don't know. But let's use one of the points that's given to me and actually figure out the equation first. Wait, figure out the b first. So I'm gonna pick this one, okay? This is positive 5 and the 2. Positive 5 and the 2. So I'm going to put the 2 over here equals to 1 over negative 2, which is my slope. And the x will be a positive 5 because this is a 5 and the 2, right? Remember, this is 5, 2, okay? And here's my b that's missing. So if I do the math right here, I got a 2 and a negative 5 over 2 plus a b. Now, 5 over 2 is almost like saying that it's 2.5, okay? So this is a negative 2.5. If you move it over, it becomes positive 2.5. Positive 2.5 plus a 2 down here, it gives you the 4.5, okay? So this b down here is actually just 4.5. So your final answer for the b line is just going to be y equals to, oh no, not final answer yet. It's just going to be negative 1 over 2. X plus 4.5, okay? Now, the problem is 4.5 is not a good number to use. Technically, it's actually just 9 over 2, okay? So if you actually change this, so let me remove that for a second. If you change that into a fraction, we got a 1 over 2 for the slope and a 9 over 2 for the y-intercept, right? You want to change that into like a just without the fractions. So you want to times everything by a 2. So if you do that quickly, you get a 2y over here equals to negative x plus a 9. Okay? Because if you times 2 to everything, the 2 over 2 is canceled, the 2 over 2 is canceled, it's just the y got an extra 2. And then why are we doing this? Because we want the general equation. So once you get this far, the general equation would be x plus 2y. Because I moved the x to this side right here. So the 2y stays, the x comes over here, becomes positive, and the minus 9 equals to 0. And this is the general equation for line B. Okay? Quite a bit of work, but they're not that bad. Okay? Seems like we're running out of space for the B and C, but don't worry, they're pretty quick. So for the C, there is not that much work, okay? Because it's a vertical line. So we don't need to do all those y equals mx plus b. It's a vertical line. You just have to remember, it's line on top of the x-axis. So for this one right here, without even doing anything, I can just tell you the equation. It's just x, and it's on negative 2. So it's just x equals to negative 2. So if you want to change that into the standard equation, just move everything to one side. It's just going to be x plus 2 equals to 0. And that is the general equation for C, okay? Now, if you're going to do the D, it's actually another way to look at it. It's just a straight line, a horizontal line on the y-axis, okay? And where is it? It's on somewhere around the 7. So that is just saying that it's y equals to 7, right? If you want to change that into the standard form, we're just going to put a y here and put a minus 7 equals to 0. And that is the general form for that line number D right there. And that's it. Thanks for watching.